Hey guys, first there was the Nutella, then there was the peanut butter. Both made out of beans, man. So let's see, is there another spread? We can make an anabolic version that tastes delicious. You can just slap on a piece of bread and eat guilt-free. Well, let's see now. Well, of course there is, man. That's right, we're making a Lotus Biscoff spread. So if you're new to this channel, my name is Alex. I mainly focus on anabolic recipes, so if that's what you seek, then hit this video a big like, smash that subscribe button, and let's get right into it. Roll the intro. Okay, so this is a very simple recipe. There is really nothing to it. There are just a few ingredients, and we just have to blend everything up in our Ninja Blender. That's it. Nothing fancy, the easiest thing ever. So, what are we waiting for? Let's get this show on the road. Food scale. Check. Ninja Blender pitcher. Check. Beans. Check. But not just any beans. These are canned beans. They are cooked beans. I don't want to see that comment again. Like, bro, do you use raw or cooked beans in your recipe? Come on, man, we're blending beans. Do you really think we're blending raw beans? Does this look like a raw bean to you? Come on. We're gonna need 130 grams of canned cooked beans. Borlotti beans, of course. And that's 131, but it doesn't matter. One extra bean won't make or break the recipe. Next, we'll need 50 grams of casein, vanilla flavored. By the way, I use casein from my protein, in case you wonder. Next, we'll add 2 grams of cinnamon. Next, we'll need 60 grams of skimmed milk. So you'll probably need to adjust the quantity of milk based on the absorption capabilities of your casein. So if you use casein from MyProtein, 60 grams will do it. If you use any other brand, you'll have to adjust the moisture, because I don't know exactly how absorbent your casein will be. And of course, the main ingredient, we'll need 6 Lotus Biscoff biscuits or crackers or whatever you like to call these. You can just crush them up. They will be blended anyway. Just level this up a bit and blend away. Of course you'll need to scrape the blender. What, you thought you'd escape scraping? No way. I know things are looking kind of dry at the beginning, but it will soon turn into this thick consistency that resembles the Biscoff spread. So one more go at the blender, and that should do it. You'll end up with something like this. You don't want to have too much moisture in this. It will be a rather thick paste. And that's it. That's all we need to do. So, taste test time. Okay, wasn't that the quickest thing ever? So, we're already at the taste test? That's too easy, man. Biscoff spread. Look at that. Thick, creamy, cinnamony. It really smells like cinnamon in the whole kitchen now. That smells amazing. And I already know it tastes amazing too, because this is not the first time I'm eating this, so. Let's check the calories and macros. This makes like 290 grams. Do you know how many calories there are in 290 grams of the original Biscoff spread? Check that out. That's crazy, man. That's 1740 calories. Can you believe that shit? For this amount of spread. Now, let's compare those calories and macros to the anabolic version. Check that out. The anabolic version is 3 times lighter than the original one. So, for the same quantity, you get 3 times lower the calories, or you can eat 3 times more of the stuff. But I hope you're gonna take the lower calories and not the higher volume on this one. Eating that amount of Biscoff spread won't be good on your tummy, man. Okay, so we've seen the calories, we've seen the macros, they are awesome. Let's give this a quick taste test. Let me just grab a piece of bread, a knife, and let's see how we can spread this cream. Look at that thickness, man. Now you can make it thicker, thinner, based on your preference. I like this really thick. That's why I didn't add a lot of moisture to it. If you like this a bit thinner, add more skim milk to it. It's no problem, man. You control the moisture in this. You are in control. I like mine a bit drier, a bit thicker, because to me, it resembles the thickness of an actual Biscoff spread, so we also get close texture-wise. Taste test time. That tastes amazing, guys. If you like the Biscoff biscuits, if you like cinnamon, if you like this type of spread, trust me, try this out. You won't regret it, man. The thickness is really there. The cinnamon taste is there. As you have noticed, I didn't add any sweetener here because I believe it's sweet enough from the casing and from the biscuits themselves, the crackers, whatever. But if you want this sweeter, you can add sweetener. If you want this to be thinner, like more moisture in here, you can add more skim milk. It's entirely up to you, man. Of course, this doesn't taste exactly like the Biscoff spread because that has a ton of fat. In case you didn't notice that in the calories and macros, let me show you the amount of fat again in the original Biscoff spread and in my anabolic version. So every single time, man, every single damn time, more fat equals more taste. So if you want more taste to this, you'll need to incorporate some fat. You can just as easily add some coconut oil to it, but trust me, it won't improve by a large amount because it doubles up the calories and it doesn't double up on the taste. So to me, adding no fat, just beans to this makes a decent 8 out of 10. It's in the circle and I can say no to the original spread. So there you have it, guys. There you have the Biscoff spread made out of borlotti beans. So if you like this type of content, if you like anabolic recipes, if you like my mug, hit that like button, smash that subscribe button, hit the bell notification icon so you get notified every time I put out a new awesome recipe such as this one. Check out my lowest calorie cookbook. This recipe is already added there. You pay for it once, you get lifetime updates free of charge. So that's it for today's recipe. I'm calling it a day, so I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.